this video, we'll show you how to use the latest bleeding-edge large language model from Google, specifically PaLM 2, and access that model using SQL. The specific implementation approach is with BigQuery and Google Cloud Functions, which will give us a sort of bridge from our SQL-based analytic systems to the PaLM AI model. The use of BigQuery remote functions for this setup will require just a couple dozen lines of Python, and then we'll be able to use the PaLM AI model seamlessly and effortlessly in our BigQuery SQL queries. So let's jump into the Google Cloud Console to start setting this up. We'll create a Git repository for all our code, and we'll share this in the description of the video. Let's first focus on our cloud function. This is the code that reaches out to the PaLM AI model through Vertex AI and gets responses from it. Now, this is pretty standard code for the text generation model and Vertex AI specifically. We're setting up a project and then using a few parameters to submit to our model a prediction. Specifically, we're going to use, for the prompt, the data that we get from our Google Cloud function request. We'll provide some documentation in the description of this video for how BigQuery remote functions send data and expect data to be returned, but essentially, we get these calls in the request JSON and need to return replies. A second generation cloud function should be fine. We do want to require authentication for this cloud function, and we'll configure that in BigQuery later on. For the CPU setting and memory, we can keep things relatively low. I'm going to choose to bump up the memory just a little bit, which will also increase our CPU. While there are a number of other configurations that we can tune around networking, security, and the runtime environment, the defaults should be pretty good for us. Within our configuration here, let's select a Python environment. Specifically, we'll use 3.10 and we'll bring in that code from our function script. We also need to change the entry point here to match the code and import this Vertex AI module. We'll do this through the Google Cloud AI Platform package. We'll use the 1.27.0 version and then can deploy the function. While this function is being created, let's go ahead and grab the URL. Paste that into your notes so that you can easily access it later. It looks like we've crossed the finish line in deploying the Cloud Function service. Now, we'll dive into BigQuery and set the stage for the remote functions apparatus. Our plan includes the creation of a dataset, which we'll name Demo. We'll pick the US multi-region and accept all the other default options. Next, let's establish the external connection using this Add button in the Explorer. Turn on the API if that's called for. As for the connection type, we'll choose Remote Functions and assign a connection ID of something like PaLM. We'll stick to the US region, but other than that, we're good to go. A key point is that initializing this connection gives us a service account that we need to tie into our cloud function. Let's take care of that right now. A visit to our cloud function, specifically the permissions page, will present us with a useful command on how we can introduce our service account to this cloud function with the invoker permissions. Before I copy-paste this command, let's jot down the BigQuery connection's service account ID to free up the clipboard. Moving forward, we'll run this command and swap out the member name for our service account. The error here suggests that we need to supply the service account prefix. No problem. There's also the option of using the manual interface and granting access, but the command in the Cloud Shell offers a more streamlined approach. Regardless, now that we've tackled that permission, let's circle back to BigQuery and tie up some of the loose ends. Our next move is to set up a remote function, creating it directly in the SQL workspace with the command of this structure. We'll need our endpoint, which we copied earlier from the Cloud Functions interface. Our query validator gives us the green light that this command will work. Also note that highlighted here are the types we're going to utilize for inputs and outputs for this remote function. We'll be using an input string and an output string. Expanding our dataset reveals our new function making its grand entrance. To keep this function creation SQL in our back pocket for future reference, you might want to save the query. Our stage is now set to leverage the remote function in queries. Here's a simple query with the remote function at its core. We're creating a prompt with a prefix and a data field, with the data being created on the fly with the select statement. However, you can feel free to utilize existing tables and all the SQL joins, filters, and transformations that you're accustomed to. Our analysis includes a user, John or Jane, their review, either I love this product or I hate this product, and an estimation of the review's positivity. Let's fire this off. Each of these elements are showing up nicely. The data for user satisfaction is the result of SQL-based, on-the-fly PaLM AI usage. Thanks to our earlier machinery, we're able to harness that LLM with SQL in BigQuery, and we're left with a remarkably smooth interface for analytics. Bear in mind that this solution does not circumvent rate limits or costs, it just offers an alternative-friendly interface. This approach could be particularly useful for those who avoid more general purpose programming languages like Python and prefer to use SQL. We hope that this video has been helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.